Good day everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to change a thermostat on a BMW 320i F30 2012 model. As you can see, I already bought the new one, hopefully it is the correct one. First, we have to start removing the filter box. This one here, you can see there's a rubber holding it down there, there and there. You just basically pull that up, but first you need to release this pipe here. Once that's released, you can loosen the rubbers. Also, don't forget these two as well. As you can see, they just pop out like that. And they're loose. There you can see the filter at the bottom. Next step you want to do is remove this plug here, as well as the clamp there, so that the box can slide out. Okay, you just pull back on the clip there, pull it out. Just loosen that, then you just can just pick up the filter box like that. Side, you see there's your filter. Then as you can see inside, it's a bit dark here. You can see there is the old thermostat we want to remove. So we need to take out this filter here with these pipes going down there. The filter is easy, you just pick it up, then it's loose. The box here, you also just take it and pick it up. And it's loose. Put it aside. And you can see what's going on inside here. Okay, you just remove this one by pulling back one of those clamps, taking it out. This is just a breather pipe. Remove this plug here, then this pipe comes out, and remove that clamp there. And then this pipe comes out so that we can work there. Once the pipe is out, take off that connection there and make sure you put something in the pipe so that the water does not enter here. Because once we're going to remove this set clip here, all the water will come out here, as well as the clamp there and this clamp here. I think we're going to first start with the one at the bottom so that all the water drains out underneath. So, as you can see, I removed this circlip and this pipe just pulled out. Loosen that clamp, pipe pulled out, loosen that clamp, pipe pulled out. Now there's the thermostat. I don't know if you can see underneath there. Let me show you on the new one. Here's the new one, situated like that. So there's two bolts here that you need to loosen. If I'm not mistaken, they are Torx screws T30. As you can see, the thermostat is now out, and here is the old thermostat, complete with its housing. It was a battle to get those two bolts out. That one and that one, but it's manageable. Okay, now we just need to install the new one. Easy as that. New thermostat installed. All that you do now is install everything as you remove them. That pipe goes there, that one goes there, this one goes there, this plug goes inside there, this plug goes in the pipe. And this pipe is situated there, the sensor goes there. As you can see, I did not remove this pipe because I thought if I opened there and the water leaks out here, all the water will go inside there, so I kept it closed there. And once all those pipes are installed, you take the air box, this one, put it back on its place like that, and then this air box that pipe goes in there, and the sensor just need to reconnect the sensor there, the sensor, yeah. And just clip everything back together, these clips and the rubbers here, the press inside here, this one goes in there. Once everything is back together, you open up the bleed screw, that one there, as well as that one there. Just plastic screws like this. Open them up. Then you pour in your antifreeze until the antifreeze comes out at that bleed screw. Then you close it. The antifreeze that I bought, this is the bottle. Normally, you pour in the blue antifreeze in the BMWs. And once there's not, when if there's not blue antifreeze in, don't mix the colors. If there's yellow in, you pour in yellow again. Make sure not to mix the colors. When you close all the bleed screws, this one at the bottom, finished pouring it, if the system's got enough fluid in, then you do the procedure. Okay, what you do then is climb inside the car. Okay, what you do then is you switch the ignition on. As you can see, the ignition is switched on. You put the fan on low and the temp on max. And then you press in the accelerator pedal for 10 seconds. Okay, that'll switch on the electric water pump if your car has an electric water pump. Not to close the door while you're bleeding the electronic water pump, otherwise it will shut off automatically and you need to restart everything. Then it will bleed the system like this. This is the correct procedure with the bleed screws closed, and then you're finished, 100% complete. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you.